Hello my dear students, today we are going to learn about the boron family. Here we discuss some aspects of group 13 elements, normally called the boron family. They form the first family among the P block elements. That is, here the differentiating electron enters an outermost P orbital of their individual atoms. Elements in the boron group include boron, aluminium, gallium, indium, thallium, and nihonium. The scientists who discovered the boron family members are shown in the table. These are the most abundant forms of boron family members in nature. Here we discuss some aspects of group 13 elements. These include electronic configuration, atomic size, density, melting point, boiling point, ionization energy, metallic character, oxidation state, electronegativity, standard electrode potential, and chemical properties. The general outer electronic configuration of group 13 elements is NS2NP1. Here, boron and aluminium have inert gas type of configuration in the penultimate shell, whereas gallium, indium, thallium have pseudo inert gas type configuration. Then what do you mean by inert gas type electronic configuration and pseudo inert gas type configuration? Here, Lewis postulated that the inert gas atoms are chemically inert because they hold 8 valence electrons. The valence electron pattern in this atom is called an inert gas electronic configuration. The pseudo inert gas configuration means having 18 electron instead of 8 electron in penultimate shell after gaining or losing electron. The next general characteristic is atomic radius. On moving down the group, atomic radius increases. We know the radius of an atom is governed by two factors: the number of shells of electrons around the nucleus and the attraction of the outer electrons field from the nucleus. The attraction of the outer electrons field from the nucleus depends upon the shielding effect. Electrons in an atom can shield each other from the pull of the nucleus. This effect is called shielding effect. That is, electron between the nucleus and valence electrons repel each other and making the atom larger. On moving down the group, nuclear charge increases, number of shells increases in each step, causing the valence electron to be farther from the nucleus, and shielding effect of the inner electron increases down the group. The combined effect of number of shells increases and shielding effect outweighs the shrinking effect caused by increased nuclear charge. So, atomic and ionic size, atomic volume increases on moving down the group, except in the case of gallium. On moving from boron to aluminium, there is a large increase in atomic radius occurs. This is due to the strong shielding effect of S and P electrons in aluminium. But on moving from aluminium to gallium, atomic radius decreases. That is, the atomic radius of gallium is less than that of aluminium. It is due to the poor shielding effect of d orbital electrons. So, increased nuclear charge is more felt on the outer electrons in gallium and atomic radius decreases. The shielding effect of penultimate shell electrons of indium and thallium is also poor. So, a small increase in atomic size is seen as we move from gallium to indium to thallium. The next general property is density. As we move down the group, atomic mass increases and also atomic volume increases. The effect of increasing atomic mass outweighs the effect of increasing atomic volume. So, density increases down the group. The next general property is ionization energy. We know ionization energy is governed by three factors: the charge on the nucleus, the amount of screening by the inner electrons, and the distance between the outer electrons and the nucleus. As we move down the group, nuclear charge increases, atomic size increases, and screening effect increases. The combined effect of increase in atomic size and screening effect outweighs the shrinking effect caused by increased nuclear charge. So ionization energy decreases on moving down the group, but regular gradation is not seen in group 13. The irregularities arise due to the imperfect shielding effect of the d and f electrons, which in turn is due to the diffuse shape and lower penetrating power of the d and f orbitals. We are expecting that first ionization energy decreases on moving down the group. Here, a sharp decrease in ionization energy from boron to aluminium is due to the appreciable increase in atomic size and the screening effect of the s and p electrons of the penultimate shell. But in the case of aluminium and gallium, the ionization energy of gallium is slightly higher than that of aluminium. This is due to the poor shielding effect of inner electrons of gallium and small atomic radius of gallium as compared to that of aluminium. From gallium to indium, there is a decrease in ionization energy due to increase in atomic size. But the decrease is not much. This is due to the poor shielding effect of d electrons. But there is an increase in ionization energy as we move from indium to thallium. This is due to the poor shielding effect of inner d and f electrons. The next general property is metallic character or electropositive character. Boron possesses a metalloidal character, while the remaining elements, aluminium, gallium, indium and thallium, are metals with a relatively similar electropositive character. The next general characteristic is oxidation state. All the elements of group 13 show a common oxidation state of +3. Boron forms only covalent compounds in which it shows +3 oxidation state. That is, boron does not form it is +3 ion because of it is small atomic size and high ionization energy. Boron shows -3 oxidation state in metal borides. As we move down the group, due to poor shielding effect of intervening d and f orbitals, the increased effective nuclear charge holds the two ns electrons tightly and thereby restricts their participation in bonding. This is called inert pair effect. So gallium, indium, thallium show both +1 and +3 oxidation state, and the stability of +1 oxidation state increases down the group. The thallus ion is more stable than thallic ion in aqueous solution. This is due to inert pair effect. That is, the relative stability of +1 oxidation state is more than that of +3 oxidation state. So thallic salts act as strong oxidants. The next general property is standard electrode potential. We know standard electrode potential are defined by measuring the potential related to a standard hydrogen electrode using 1 mole solution at 25 degrees Celsius at 1 atmosphere pressure. The larger value of the standard reduction potential, the easier it is for the element to be reduced. That is, they are oxidizing agents. The smaller value of standard electrode potential means that it is easier for the element to be oxidized. That is, they are reducing agents. From the table, it is clear that standard reduction potential increases on moving down the group. That is, it becomes less difficult to reduce on moving down the group. The next general property is electronegativity. Electronegativity does not show a gradual variation down the group. There is a decrease from boron to aluminium, then there occurs an increase as we move further down the group. This is due to the poor shielding effect of inner d and f electrons. The next general characteristics are melting and boiling point. The variation of melting point is not regular. Melting point decreases sharply from boron to gallium and then increases on moving on to indium and then to thallium down the group. This irregularity is due to having different crystal structures. Then what is the specialty of the crystal structure of boron atom? The allotropic forms of boron have icosahedral crystal structure. consisting of B12 units. Here, boron atom situated at its 12 vertices. Due to its strong crystalline lattice consisting of B12 icosahedra packed together, boron is an extremely hard solid and has an unusually high melting point. Gallium has a very low melting point. Its melting point is 30 degrees Celsius. It can exist as a liquid on a hot day. It melts in a closed palm of the hand and solidifies again when kept open if the room temperature is below its melting point. Then why gallium has a very low melting point? Do you know? The stable solid phase of gallium under normal condition is orthorhombic, with 8 gallium atoms in one conventional unit cell. Within a unit cell, each gallium atom has only one nearest neighbor at 244 picometer and has the remaining 6 neighbors spaced farther away at distances between 271 and 283 picometer. That is, 2 each at distances 271, 274 and 283 picometer. The bonding between two nearest neighbors is predominantly covalent, so effectively leading to a situation equivalent to having discrete gallium 2 molecules. That is, gallium exists as dimer. It is the fundamental building block of the crystal. As a result, gallium has a very low melting point, but it has high boiling point. So, among the metals, gallium has a large temperature range of existence for its liquid form. So, it is a useful material for measuring high temperature. All the group 13 elements have high boiling point. The boiling point decreases down the group because atomic size increases as we move from top to bottom. So the strength of intermolecular force between them is also decreases. So it becomes easy to break bonds between them. So the boiling point decreases down the group. Next, we can discuss about chemical properties of group 13 elements. The group 13 elements form electron deficient compounds. We know group 13 elements have the NS2-NP1 outer electronic configuration. There can be a maximum of 6 electrons only in the valence shell when 3 covalent bonds are formed by electron sharing. Boron forms covalent compounds only. The tendency to form covalent compounds decreases and the tendency to form ionic compounds increases as we move down the group. Firstly, reaction with water. Here, reactivity increases down the group. Boron does not react with cold or boiling water. It reacts with steam at red heat and liberating hydrogen. Pure aluminum is not affected by water at ordinary temperature due to the formation of an unreactive layer of oxide on the metal surface. But aluminum reacts to some extent with the boiling water or with the steam at red heat and to yield hydrogen gas. In the absence of oxygen, gallium and indium do not react even with boiling water. Thallium does not react with air-free water. Thallium metal tarnishes slowly in moist air and reacts readily with steam and to produce thallium oxide. Thallium dissolves in hot water and to give thallium hydroxide. Next, we can consider the formation of group 13 halides. All group 13 elements form trihalides. They are nonpolar with a trigonal planar shape. The halides of boron are all volatile, highly reactive, covalently bonded molecular compounds and are gases. The boron fluoride form fluoroborates, while other boron halides giving boric acid when reacting with water. The covalent character of trihalide decreases and ionic character increases down the group. Being electron deficient in nature, the group 13 trihalide acts as Lewis acids and form addition compounds with Lewis bases. Boron trihalide exists as discrete molecule, whereas the trihalides of other group 13 elements exist as dimers in the vapor state and in nonpolar solvents. Except boron, the other group 13 elements form monohalides. Many are unstable. Indium monohalide can be prepared by heating the metal in limited amount of the halogen. The other group 13 monohalides are prepared by heating the trihalide with the metal. The stability of the monohalide increases down the group. This is due to the inert pair effect. That is, the plus one oxidation state becomes more common on moving down the group. Next, we can consider the formation of hydrides. Here, it does not react directly with the hydrogen, but form hydrides of the type MH3, which can be prepared indirectly. The stability of the hydride decreases as we move down the group. That is, boron hydride is the most stable and thallium hydride is the least stable. Due to their electron deficient character, the hydride acts as Lewis acids, so it readily forms adducts with a strong Lewis bases. It also forms trihydridoanions. For example, lithium aluminium hydride is used as a reducing agent in organic chemistry. Today, we discussed the general characteristics of boron family. In the next part, we will discuss about Lewis acidity of boron halides.